In this film, we're going to look at how to combine oscillators within the ES1 and then apply a series of different envelope approaches to shaping a sound that we're going to build there. So for a start, let's have a look at the architecture of the ES1. What we've effectively got within this instrument is two separate oscillators, the main oscillator, which is called the wave oscillator, and then a sub oscillator. And you can see the two things are here, wave at the top and sub at the bottom. And what we've got is a slider between the two, which allows us to set the balance for the two oscillators, which you can see here. Okay, so first of all, let's have a look at this main wave oscillator. What we've really got here are three different oscillator types. One of them has a bit of a twist. First of all, we've got this sawtooth wave, then we've got a triangle wave here, and then we've got a square wave, which becomes a rectangle wave via what we call variable width. Let's have a listen to the sawtooth first. And now the triangle. And now that square wave. So you can hear how the sound modifies as we vary the pulse width. And you can see also that the cutoff frequency at the moment is wide open. That's going to be important in a little while. Okay, so let's blend in some of the sub-oscillator. So you can hear how the balance between the oscillators changes. Okay, so once I've set the shape that I want for the sub-oscillator, I can then set the mix balance between the two. And as we were going around there, you probably heard the noise generator amongst other waveforms available for the sub-oscillator. Now let's start shaping our sound with the filter. And now that we've got the slightly more muted tone, let's start shaping it with the ADSR envelope as well. So you can hear how opening the sound takes it from this kind of organ-like pad to something brighter and a bit raspier. Okay, so now let's have a look at how we can use the mod envelope to get involved in the sound as well by shaping a bass sound. I'm using the ADSR envelope to shape the sound so that it has no sustain level and a shorter decay. Now that sounds clicking a little bit at the beginning, so I'm just going to adjust the attack time so it's a bit longer. I'm going to lengthen the decay time too. And now what we've got is a sound which is a bit more like a synth bass or a synth sequence sound. But what I also want to do is to get in some bite via the mod envelope affecting cutoff. So I'm going to set a quick little decay in here. Close the filter up a little bit more. And now I'm going to lengthen the sustain time, which gives me this nice sub bottom end to my attacky synth bass sound. And there it is, shorter again. So as you've seen within this video, what we've done is to combine the two oscillators within the ES1. We've set the filter shape that we want for that sound. We've applied a modulation envelope to the cutoff frequency, and we've used the ADSR envelope to shape our sound to produce this synth bass or sequence sound as well. Lots of things working at once.